बिगिनर्स आई सजेस्ट दैट स्टार्ट योर वर्क फ्रॉम ड्राफ्टिंग एंड एनोटेशन. सो एवरी वन हु इज लर्निंग विथ मी ही हैज टू स्विच टू वर्क स्पेस टू द 2D ड्राफ्टिंग एंड एनोटेशन. इट मीन्स यू आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट ओनली 2D ऑब्जेक्ट्स. इट इज कंपल्सरी फॉर द बिगिनर्स टू लर्न 2D बिफोर स्विचिंग 3D. सो वी विल बी लर्निंग इन 2D एंड ड्राफ्टिंग एनोटेशन एंड वी विल बी कवरिंग डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ मेन्यूज प्रेजेंट इन द इंटरफेस. सो वी हैव कवर्ड AutoCAD menu, we have covered Quick Access menu, we have covered Universal menu, we have covered Ribbon, we have covered Tool Palettes, we have covered Toggle button which changes the different type of interfaces, and we have covered Workspace area, we have covered different type of tabs. Now there are different type of interface present inside your workspace. We will be getting three things present inside your workspace. A black area, we will be getting three types of interface in the workspace also. So we will have to know that also. For that, I have to create some 3D object. If you want to learn about these view options, there are basically view options, View cube and navigation. These three are present in your workspace. So for these three, I have to create a 3D object so you can understand what these three will be doing. So for that, you need not to worry about how I am going to create. Just you can understand what these interfaces do. So I will create a 3D object here. I will be creating a rectangle. Now I will be clicking on home button. This will switch to a 3D interface. Now you are clicking, seeing that your 2D interface have been switched to the 3D. Because these commands are related to the 3D, so we have to create a 3D object, then after learn that. There is one command called press pull. Using that, we create a 3D object and extrude. You need not to worry, I will be covering these commands in further lectures. Just I am creating a 3D box. This is your 3D box. Because we have to cover these three tools. If I make a list of these three tools here, then we are going to cover these three tools. Number one tool is view controls. Number two is view cube. And number three is navigation bar. Covering these three, we need to create an 3D object. Sometimes you will not find these in your interface. How? If I go to View tab, please focus on this because if we are going to cover these tools and these tools are not present in your interface, then you will be confused. In the View tab, like in the universal menu, I am going to the View tab. In View tab, you are seeing some things are highlighted. First, UCS icon is highlighted, View cube is highlighted, navigation bar is highlighted, Files tab is highlighted, Layout tabs is highlighted. So all these you can show and hide. It means UCS icon you are seeing at the bottom side. This is your UCS icon, XY, which is showing right side bottom. You are finding here UCS icon, that is your XYZ axis. View cube, you are seeing view cube, which we are going to cover. After that, navigation bar, a bar existing below side the view cube. And files tab means you are getting drawing, annotate, drawing start. These are called file tabs. And layout tabs are at the bottom side. You can show and hide them also. UCS icon, click on UCS icon, your UCS icon will be disappearing. You can click on your view cube will be disappearing. Navigation bar is also disappearing. It means these interface icons you can hide. So before going to reset, you have to come once on the view tab also. Click on UCS icon, that is coming back. Click on view cube icon, view cube is coming back. Navigation bar is coming back. Layout tab, it means before going to reset, you have to go to view tab also, and you can show and hide these also. If you are not getting these things on your interface, then you will go to the view and click on these are present inside the interface. One more interesting thing, covering the interface, I should not go for that, but for creating the creating some excitement type thing, I generally prefer to show some exciting things here. If we go to the tool palettes, here is a one tool palette. If we turn on tool palettes, then one interface will be showing here. You will get here civil means, in civil drawings we use several type of things. We want to create a gate, we can create a gate directly. If we click on mechanical, you can create different type of nut bolt drawing. If you want to create a nut bolt, then you need not to draw that. You can drag it and drop it in your interface. A beautiful nut bolt drawing will be appearing. It means several types of things are created for different architecture, annotation, construction, modeling, electrical, civil, different type of these things will be available with AutoCAD interface. You can change them, but for now I will hide this tool palette. For our convenience, I will delete this nut bolt. Basically we are covering interface here. If you are not getting these view cube in your interface, this navigation bar in an interface, and this UCS icon in your interface, you have to come to the view and turn on whichever you want to see. Coming back to the home, now we will be covering this view. Basically here are three things. We can show hide these things from view. At the same time, you will get a minus sign very carefully, because this is very small size minus sign. Then there are two type of views. If I discuss about view controls, then there are two type of views of any object. One is observer view, and one is object view. Observer view means your object is same. You have put a ball on the table, then the ball is same. And observer means you are moving around the table, then this will be observer view. means position of the observer is different. It means I have created an object here and the object is same, but once I view from this side, once I view from this side, and once I view from this side, then there will be different type of views: top view, side view, left side view, right hand side view. This also can be controlled from view. It means if you click on this top, then you will get a list: top, bottom, left, right, front, southwest isometric. I hope everyone have covered basic machine drawing. It means you can view your object from four corners. If I tell here, then you can view from this corner, that is one isometric view. You can view from this corner side, this is second isometric view, and this corner. Basically we have four horizontal corners, so there are four isometric views. So in the AutoCAD interface you will get top. When you click on the top, then you will get top, bottom, left, right, south, west, isometric. These are basically your observer views. It means first of the view control, there are three view controls. One is minus, you can change, show and hide several things, and one is top. If you click on that, then you will get observer view. After that, in the third bracket, there are basically in bracket there are three bracket things. One is 2D wireframe. It means you are going to change the object now. You can view, change the observer view. You can view from the top side, you can view the bottom side, you can view the left side, and you can change the object type. Object type means, if we coming to AutoCAD interface, if I click on home, then you are seeing this is your 2D wireframe. This view icon is showing now 2D wireframe. If I click on that, if we click on this 2D wireframe, then you will get a conceptual. If you click on the conceptual, the view of your object is changed. It means you are changing your object type. It means how you are going to view the object. Basically, you are not going to change the object, but the view of the object. 2D wireframe means its outer lines is visible to you. The view is other. Conceptual interface, you are seeing some 3D object. After that, there is a hidden. Hidden means the gray color will be hidden. After that, realistic. Means if you really create the object, then how will it show? It shows you color. If you place copper material on that, then it will be showing as a copper. That is your realistic view. In real, which will be showing. In conceptual, basically you realize the shape of the object, but in real life, conceptual, that is a realization of the shape, means you can consider, you can check the how the shape is, but if you come to realistic, then this is actual product you have created. After that, there is shaded with edges. There are different type of view types are available. Basically we see only three are important for us. One is conceptual, you can view shape, you can 2D wireframe or 3D wireframe. 2D wireframe, using 2D wireframe you can grip back side corners also. It means if you want to go to the back side corner from this view, you cannot go. If you want to cache the back side corner in 2D wireframe, then you can cache this back side corner also. It means you have to switch during 3D modeling, you have to switch these type of views. So we are not going to cover in detail. We will be covering in detail that in 3D. Basically, we are covering only the interface items. You can click on minus to show and hide view cube, steering wheel and navigation bar. You can click on custom view to view the top view, bottom view, left view, means observer position you can change, and after that object position you can change. So this was your view control which is present your in your interface. After that, I am coming to the view cube. The same thing which your view control button has done, same thing you are seeing in the view cube visually. You are seeing top here. If you click on top, then top view will be appearing in the interface. If you click on the corner, then this corner view will be appearing on the interface. If you click on the side, then this side view will be appearing on that. It means using view cube, you can change those views as per your convenience. You can these things, and northwest, southwest is also showing. It means you can place direction when you are creating some map. Then you will need northwest, southeast also. So this view cube is basically showing different type of, if you click on left, then left view will be available. Yeah, arrow button is available here. Then it can rotate also. You can rotate also from here at 90 degree. You have to remember that it rotates and in 90 degree only. And you can click one corner and rotate as per your convenience also. Not necessarily that you rotate only 90 degree. You can pick a corner and drag it to rotating. So it will be rotating. View cube, basically you can change your view. Object is not changing. So the same thing you can do from here, you can do from here also. The view cube shows you the position of your object on the table. North, west, south, east is basically a table, and your object is placed as this cube. And you can use this view cube to identify your object's location and position. So this is basically view cube. Along with the view cube, you will get a steering wheel. For the steering wheel, I will cover in some other lecture. Because that needs a separate attention. We can cover whole 2D without steering wheel. During 3D we will need steering wheel, so I will cover steering wheel in further lectures. After the this is called, basically these whole are called navigation. So I will be showing these things in realistic view, so you can visualize this. So I will go to the some conceptual view or realistic view. After that, we are getting here pan. If you want to pan means without changing the size of the object, placing the object at different place. It means pan means you are gripping the object and moving the object without changing its size. That is pan. You can grip. It is similar that we pick a mobile from your table and place to other place. Mean mobile size is not changing, but you can drag and drop here. After that, you can see zoom. There are different type of zooms. Multiple time we zoom the our object very large, we are not getting any corner, then you can press this zoom extend button. Whatever your object size is, it becomes in your space. You can create your object very small, then your object is not appearing, then also you can use zoom extend and your object will be in the screen size. So this is basically useful when you have created very large drawing and you are not able to view whole drawing in your interface, then you can use zoom extend. Zoom extend means wherever is your drawing, whether it is very large, whether it is very small, it zooms to your screen level. After that, you are getting orbit. Orbit has two types, free orbit and continuous orbit. So in free orbit, you can roll your mouse you can roll your mouse and your object will be rotating. And in continuous orbit, you move your object will be rotating continuously. This is your continuous orbit. Your object will be rotating continuously until you stop that. So you can view your object in different orientations using this orbit tool. And after the orbit tool, at the last, it shows you history. History means in the past, what type of things you have done. It shows you history. Basically, we have created only one object and we have not provided motion in that. So there is no history available. So we are basically, this shows you history of your object. How have you created object? How you have rotated the object? This shows you the history. Basically, these are view cube. This is your navigation bar. So all these inner side you have done. After that, sometimes you have to print your drawing. So we have a layout here, layout 1. So you can see that your object is inside the page. If you print, then this type of print will be available. And layout, this is basically your print layout. How will it be visible on the paper? And in the model space, you have your object. It means at the bottom side, you have three tabs. One is model, in which you create your object. In the layout, it shows the print layout. And the layout too, sometimes we create a multi-layer drawing. It means you are creating first floor, second floor, third floor, and you need to present your first floor only. Then you can hide the second floor. So there are multiple layouts. You can create one more layout also. Click plus on for the new layout. You can add multiple layouts for the same object. So this is your layout. This is also an interface item. After that, you are viewing this icon, which is generally present at the bottom. This is present at bottom side. That is called command line. Whatever task you do, it systematically records whatever I have done here. It systematically records everything. If I click on that, then you can see here whichever I have done, it has its history. So this is basically command line. In the place of using your mouse, you can type this command line and create an object. After that, at the bottom side, you are getting, that is called task pane. that is called task pane. In which you have different type of controls. I will be covering this in next lectures.